Hotel Sahara Star, Mumbai for the 6th Annual India Leadership Conclave and Business Leadership Awards, organizing by Indian Affairs. So let's have a look.
Many dignitaries from various industries participated in the event.
We got the independence from the British Raj. We felt that we have been liberated from them. But there is a bigger message here now. While I'm an optimist and take everything into the right spirit, I don't see a near future which is coming out to be bright because of multiple factors that is affecting Indian fabrics, its cultural harmony, its secular nature and economics. So I hope to present you a fantastic day for you, and I sincerely hope that you will enjoy everything and would give you an ultimate leadership experience. With these notes, I'm concluding. Thank you very much.
Our lives are seamlessly interwoven with the stories our stakeholders hear and say about us. Our job as leaders is to accept, acknowledge, and exhibit consistent action. That's the only way we get in conversation with our stakeholders. We're called human beings and not human doings. So being in the moment, being present in the moment, and having authentic conversations with our stakeholders is a very important part of having influential conversations.
We are a multi-religious and a multicultural community, and that is our strength. But unfortunately, it sometimes also becomes a vulnerability. I would say that except a small minority in every religion, most people would be progressive, liberal, and would echo what, interestingly, Madani had told Musharraf when he had come. Have you all heard it? Somehow conceived to be speaking against the religion. So we need to really inculcate within ourselves an amount of tolerance, which is actually naturally present in Indians more than it is present in any other country. Because when a lot of religions are there together, we are a melting pot. Where everyone comes together, we generally learn love, compassion and empathy.
Top leaders from various sectors of the society had a panel discussion on the Indian economy.
What are the problems that you're facing while executing the projects of your clients, especially those projects which are abroad? I remember once you told me that you're in Indonesia, and other time you told me that you're in Jakarta. So are you facing the same problems abroad, or is it the same like in India actually?
Yeah, of course, any Asian countries is as good as India. See, we have established company in Indonesia. It took about 1 year to have the company set up and make it fully operational. Now that we have a lot of reforms and ease of doing business, perhaps it's going to change in India.
I think three things that come to my mind when I think what are things that we need to look at very seriously. One, of course, is healthcare, and I'll want to qualify that, you know, a little more later on. The second is education, and I'll qualify that again. And the third, I think, is job creation. And I think if we don't have enough jobs for the young people that we have and the talent that we have in India, I think the youth are going to get frustrated and then they're going to get off track. Right. And so we need to have something which is able to create jobs. And according to me, education again, I'm not for formal education. I'm not looking at, you know, being the intellectual capital of the world. I think we have a long way to go. What I believe is in education, one of the strongest points that we should be looking at if we have to grow is skill development.
All right.
Because today, why is it that everybody wants to be a doctor or a lawyer? Why can't people take pride in being a plumber, a mechanic, an electrician? I mean, these are all kind of handy jobs which have so much of scope, but we don't have people doing it, and we don't have institutions which actually teach this. So skill development, I think, is one part. In education, again, it's, you know, coming to health again, it's not just health, but it's health and hygiene. You know, you spoke about Swachh Bharat, and I'm saying Swachh Bharat must be linked with Swasth Bharat. Because if we are clean, then we are healthy.
Anybody in the audience would like to ask a few questions, if you could have. Fantastic.
I have a question pointed to Dr. Mukesh Batra. I agree with almost all of what you have told. But when it comes to your own company, Sir, I would like to know what are the steps you have taken to spread homeopathy in the rural areas where I feel it's very important, especially with this type of dengue spread we have got recently. Because you are very well known in the cities and also I believe pretty pricey in the cities. I understand as an entrepreneur you also have to recover your costs. But what steps have you taken to spread your concept into the rural areas? Because I'm a very big fan of homeopathy, so I'm asking you this question.
The answer to your question is no, we are not into rural India as yet. We don't have a model which will get us there right now. We are still thinking for the last 3-4 years. We are finding a way how to get there. We haven't found an answer yet. We're still working on it. So that's the answer to one question. The second is that, having said that, we are already now in tier 3, tier 4 cities. You know, we are in 110 cities in India. And I would say any city which has a population more than 1 lakh people, you will find a Dr. Batra's clinic there. So partly, yes, we have covered, you know, that part, but we haven't gone to below 1 lakh population cities yet. And we haven't gone to rural India. We're still finding a way out.
The dignitaries were honored for the services regarding this specific field by the organizers.
Thing I always keep on asking, which is the biggest problem of India? Somebody would say poverty, somebody would say illiteracy, somebody would say injustice, somebody would say reservation. But the biggest problem in this country has always been leadership. We have never got a good leader, whether you go in business, whether you go in politics, whether you go in spiritual, whatever subject you get, you look at people, you feel wonderful leadership, the closer you get, you start seeing, oh my God, this has feet of clay. Don't you think so? That is the tragedy of this country.
मेरे ख्याल से यहाँ आप सभी बिजनेस से जुड़े हुए हैं, तो मुझे पता नहीं कि फ्री स्पीच के बारे में बात करना कितना रिलेवेंट है. हम सिनेमा को बैन करते हैं क्योंकि ये सिनेमा रिलीज होगी तो समाज में अस्थिरता फैल जाएगी, लोग सड़कों पर उतर आएंगे, दंगे होंगे, लोग पोस्टर जलाएंगे, अव्यवस्था क्रिएट करेंगे. पर इसके लिए हम उन्हें नहीं रोकते जो अराजकता फैलाते हैं, हम इसके लिए उस सिनेमा बनाने वाले को रोकते हैं, उस आर्टिस्ट को रोकते हैं, उस म्यूजिशियन को रोकते हैं, उस राइटर को रोकते हैं, उस आर्टिस्ट को रोकते हैं. और ये हमारी गलती है कि हम गलत और सही को पहचान नहीं पाते.
हाउ हार्मोन्स रियली इफेक्ट योर थॉट, हाउ हार्मोन्स रियली मेक यू व्हाट यू आर. Everybody says that हम जो हैं हमारा अंदर हमारे बाहर दिखता है, हम जो अंदर है वो हम बाहर दिखते हैं. पर वो क्या है? What's that? There has to be something. Everything has got some mediator. हम कुछ भी करते हैं कोई mediator है. When I'm talking to you sir, I'm speaking up, you are listening, that thing is going in your brain, it is going to your temporal cortex, it is then going to your parietal cortex. And then it is getting deciphered. फिर आपको समझ में आता है कि क्या मैं सही बोल रहा हूँ, क्या मैं गलत बोल रहा हूँ, और शायद उसके बाद हमारा कनेक्ट हो सकता है.
There was a panel discussion on women empowerment by successful leading business women.
All of us as women who are sitting here today and who get a chance to live a life with their heads up, with respect, should go out and extend the help towards people. We should not wait for a change. We should be the change ourselves, truly. And it is our duty as women that we go ahead and we help others. We don't wait that, okay, this the government will do something, the social service organization will do something. We all can make a change in our own little ways.
All well-known dignitaries and celebrities were awarded for their contribution.
really good, and it will always be special for me because it is my first award function that I have attended after the release of my film. And I think it's fantastic. It's really nice, cozy, glamorous, really nice.
ऐसे त्योहार में उसे ये अवार्ड मिला है और इसकी शुरुआत ऐसी हुई है ये बहुत शुभ लगता है ये त्योहार के साथ ये जो शुरुआत है मुझे लगता है कि शुभ होगा और अच्छा होगा और शुभ के साथ लाभ जुड़ा ही हुआ है
दिस इज अ गुड इवेंट इट्स आई मीन हैपनिंग एनुअली एंड आई हैव बीन पार्टिसिपेटिंग फॉर लास्ट फ्यू इयर्स आई थिंक द काइंड ऑफ पीपल हु कम हियर आर इंटेलेक्चुअल्स पीपल हु हैव अ लॉट ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड वेरियस सब्जेक्ट्स आर डिस्कस्ड हियर सो आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड एनरिचिंग एक्सपीरियंस
This is a wonderful event which brings people of different domains together on a common platform and allows them to interact in a more wholesome manner and allows them to explore better opportunities for growth and certainly I'm quite sure that this will be a very beneficial event for almost everybody over there.
I think this leadership enclave is definitely good, worth coming. Because you tend to actually understand and listen to a lot of leaders who are there in the society, who tend to tell you about so many different aspects of living.
I think such programs can help people be more aware of what they need to know. Because I think बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो हम life में benefit नहीं करते हैं because we are not aware of what's happening around us. So it's a good initiative. I think this must go on.
I'm very happy to be at this event. I have attended it. I love the speakers who are speaking, and I think this event is giving a great platform to a lot of social initiatives and a lot of people from different sections of society to come forward.
It's an interesting event. Happy to have won two awards at this event. One was as the most promising facial plastic surgeon, and the other one was for the online healthcare company which we've started, which is mediangels.com. So it was very interesting. It's keeps your spirit up to know that your work has been recognized, and we hope to work harder still.
Unfortunately, Tiger couldn't be here himself because he's shooting in Kerala. But I'm very, very honored to accept this on his behalf, and that he's getting an award like this is a very prestigious thing, and I'm very grateful. Thank you.
I'm very happy to win the award at the 6th Business Leadership Conclave. It's an award for design, innovative leadership and luxury brands. And I'm elated. I don't know what to say. I'm at a loss of words. I want to thank the people who voted for me. And I'm going to try harder and achieve better things. So thank you so much.
An award, however large or however small, is a recognition of one's journey, of one's work. I'm here to support this award ceremony. They're very kindly conferring upon me, India's most innovative designer. I'm grateful and I'm honored to be here.
I think this event is a wonderful event and a wonderful platform for different leaders, different entrepreneurs, different social workers and social entrepreneurs to come up and share their experiences, talk about government reforms, and especially in healthcare, we need a lot of reforms to take place.
This event was a great initiative taken by the Indian Affairs for the benefit and growth of the society.